Hello students, myself Rajbir, and I would like to welcome you all on behalf of Shiv Jyoti Educational Group Kota. Let's start with the poem, that is Frog in a Well. It is written by Alice Shettle. Alice Shettle is the poetess of this poem, A Frog in a Well. Now, whenever we talk about a poem, it is something like fascinating, बहुत ही मतलब ऐसा रहता है imagination वाला situation, like whenever we are imagining something, that is poet is something, poem is something when we are imagining something. It is not realistic. It is not realistic. It is just when we imagine something. So students, what I was telling you, that the world is round and deep and cool. The world is round and deep and cool in the sense you can learn it like this. The world is round, the world is deep and the world is cool. Like this you can learn it very simple. I'll show you. Suppose this is a well, okay? Now you can see the shape of the well. It is round and there are stones on stones. There are stones on stones. Ek upar ek, you can see there are stones. Like this the well is made. Now the frog is inside this well. According to him, the well is of round shape. It is very deep and it is very cool also. Okay. Now the bottom of the world's a pool. A pool in the sense where there is a water. Okay. So according to him, the bottom of the world is a pool. Jo world ka bottom hai, that is completely a pool for him. Okay. With just enough room for a frog alone. Matlab a little bit of space for a frog alone. The walls of the world are of stone on stone. You can see there are stones one upon one like this. The well is made. Okay. Now, at the top of the world, when I look up high, I can see a star in a little round sky. When he looks up at the sky, he can see a round sky is there. Okay. He can see a stars there in the little round sky. Little round sky is liye because wo ek well ke andar hai. According to him, that is only his world, right? So therefore, this is the assumption, this is the imagination of the frog. I'll just read the poem again. We have already read it, but anyways, I'm reading it again. Just listen carefully. The world is round and deep and cool. The bottom of the world's a pool with just enough room for a frog alone. The walls of the world are of stone on stone. At the top of the world, when I look up high, I can see a star in a little round sky. Now, let's see the notebook work for this. Now, let's see the notebook work of your poem, A Frog in a Well. It is written by Alice Shettle. The poetess is Alice Shettle. Now, read the extract and answer the following. This extract is there from your poem only. Now, we'll read the extract. The extract is like this. The world is round and deep and cool. The bottom of the world's a pool. The world is round and deep and cool. As I explained you, for the frog, the world is round. It is round. It is deep and it is cool. Okay. The bottom of the world's a pool. For him, the world, the well is the only world. And for him, the world is a pool. Okay. Now, let's see. You have to answer a few questions. With just enough room for a frog alone. With just enough room for a frog alone in the sense there is a space only for a frog to live in there. Okay. Who is the speaker? How do you know? Now, who is the speaker in the poem and how do we know this? Speaker is a frog. Speaker is a frog in the poem as he is saying enough space for a frog alone. He is himself saying that there is a enough space for a frog alone. Therefore, we can say that speaker is a frog. Okay. Who is the poetess of this poem? As in the starting only I have told you who is the poetess of this poem. Alice Shettle is the poetess of this poem. Who has written this poem? Alice Shettle has written this poem. Write two rhyming pairs in the poem. You have to write two rhyming pairs from the poem. That is cool, pool, high, sky. Which rhyme each other, we call them rhyming words. Okay, you can see in the extract, I can show you in the extract only. You can see, there is cool, there is pool. You can see these are the rhyming words. Okay. Thank you and have a very nice day.